Hello YouTube, it's Saturday, October 8th. Got a few more images from the Gross Network. Got them sent in this morning from October 8th, and we're working from Mayhill, New Mexico. We look at what the program has for it here. We can see that these are the position that I got off of Google Earth yesterday. And working off of minus 7 hours and daylight savings time, making it minus 6 hours. And there's not much there at Mayhill, just basically a crossroads. And we did get the printout this morning, and the printout, you can see that it starts on October 8th and works on down. And if you go down to where they start recording the images, you'll see down here where it's imaging 2, and then they have the date here, and the date's off by one day. That's why yesterday it said the 6th, even though it was the 7th. So they did the same thing today. So all these images, for some reason, they're printing a 7 on the date here instead of 8. So I'm satisfied that the date's right. I don't know why they're doing that, but it's pretty obvious from here that it is the 8th. And there's 4 images, and they're taken between 6:01 local time and around 6:10 local time, so 9 minutes. There's not going to be much of a difference at all in the position of it, so we won't even worry about that. So I've set the program up for 6:06 local time, and you can see the horizon line here and the ecliptic sends down here. It's getting pretty close. The sun's only 12 degrees below the horizon, so it's starting to get light outside. And this time I didn't have the problem with the orientation. We've got equatorial and no flip on this time. And take and zoom in. And I put the JPL position back on there just for comparison's sake. But you'll notice this star right here. That's the major star that you're going to be seeing in the images. And from here, you can see the JPL is out ahead, as it was the first time I mentioned it. And at this point in time, there's 46,000 kilometers difference between the two positions. Not that much, really. And I turned down the magnitude and the size a little bit to where it wouldn't show a tail on there and make it easier to look. And at the first image here from 6:01 this morning, and right here is the star that we're looking at right now, and you can see the pattern here. And this star, or this blotch right there and that blotch right there, are the two that are somewhat questionable. I'm not sure what those would be, but if take and zoom in on it here a little bit, and we can take and match up the stars, make sure that is the correct position. You can see your major star here, and there's a little star right here on the edge. That's this one here, and then this star there would be this one. And this is the spot that's kind of questionable. I'm not sure. There's not really much on the screen. But then you have this star here and this star there. That's this one here and this one here. And if you look out straight from our major star there, you'll see this one over here. And the other two up here, that's these two. That little star right there is that one right there. So it's a good match. I'm satisfied that it's looking good. So from that you can see that the comet should be located a little bit off of your major star, this star, and then it would be somewhere right over in here according to the minor planet center position. And if you looked at the JPL position, that would put it over closer to over in here. It would be over in here according to the JPL position. Take and move that over to the screen here. And you can see it a little bit better now. Here's your major star. This star would be this one. That star there would be that one. And you've got this spot here and that spot there. And the JPL position would have it over here. And the minor planet center position would have it somewhere over in here. The other two stars down there, that's these two. And then you got this three group here. That would be this group of three right there. So that's where it should be. Like I say, this little spot right there, not sure what that is. But that's close to where the JPL position would be. And the minor planet center position would be over in here. And this spot would be close to the minor planet center position. So, don't know which is which, but that's what we have on the screen. Here's the second image. And again, this is your major star. And they can zoom in on it there. Move it over. Zoom out of here. And you've got the same position, basically. It's only a few minutes off. So this would be your major star here. Star there. Star there. Star over there would be this one here. JPL would have it over here somewhere. Minor Planet Center would have it over here somewhere. These two here would be these two down there. Then we'll look at the next one. And the third image. This is the one from 607. And same thing, here's your major star right there in the middle. I can zoom in on that. And move it over to the edge. And like I say, looking at the same thing, this one, it's not as clear as the other ones. This star here would be this one there. That star there should be this one here. And these two down here would be these two here. And we'll look at the last image. And this one is from 610. Major star's right there. Again, it's not quite as good as the first one. Apparently, it's got to be getting light out there at this time. And that star there would probably be this one here. That star there would be this one over here. So that's what it looks like. We can zoom in a little bit more here. And go back to the first one, which appears to be the best one. This is taken at 601, right there. Major star, and then that star there. And shows something down here. That would be right around in here. And then this star here would be this one. And it shows something down here, which would be somewhere around in here. So, there you go. Just thought I'd put that out there for you. And we'll talk to you next time.